In this video, I will explain how you improve side split stretching. I will explain some muscles and why you need to train or stretch these muscles. First thing first, I need to define the movement of hip joint. What kind of movement is split? That is open leg like this. Right, open leg like 180 degrees. This movement is abduction is anatomical terminology for open leg to side. Okay, this is abduction. Then first key muscles are these guys. There are many muscles in inside part of leg. Each muscle has name. However, group of this muscle is called adductor. Adductor or adductors. Again, what is movement of abduction? Abduction is open leg. Then what is adduction? What is adductor? Adduction is opposite. Adduction is closed leg this way. So if your adductors are very tight, you can't open leg because tight adductors are inhibiting the movement of abduction. Okay, this terminology is very important. You need abduction to accomplish the side split. When your adductors are tight, you can't go abduction. Makes sense, right? Then the solution is you stretch for adductors. Is that the end? No, this is not the end. I need to tell you one thing. The range of motion of abduction for one leg is about 45 degrees for one leg. How about for both legs? It's simple. 45 times 2 equal to 90 degrees. Huh, 90 degrees. But side split is what? 180 degrees. Where is other 90 degrees coming from? So I will tell you where is that coming from. So problem is this bony bump of femur kind of hits to pelvis after you go to a 45 degrees abduction. Do you remember? Range of motion of abduction is 45 degrees. After you reach 45 degrees or more, this part of femur hits to pelvis. You can't go beyond bony structure, right? So this part is greater trochanter. Greater trochanter. So greater trochanter needs to find some space. Then you can go for more abduction, right? Then how do you find more space for greater trochanter? Okay, this is greater trochanter. If you go abduction 45 degrees, that hits to pelvis. You need to find the other way. There are two solutions you can do. One solution is your hip goes to external rotation. External rotation. Then your greater trochanter goes posteriorly, then there's more space for pelvis and greater trochanter, right? If you bring your hip joint to external rotation, greater trochanter finds more space. Huh, easy. And there's one another solution. You bring your pelvis to anterior way. It's kind of a, you tuck pelvis anteriorly. This movement is anterior tilt. Anterior tilt. Then your greater trochanter finds the way. Better way is you combine anterior tilt and external rotation, then you can do abduction more. The problem is what kind of muscles inhibit these two movements. Let me explain that. Again, you need anterior tilt for pelvis. The question is what kind of muscles inhibit anterior tilt. The main muscles are these guys. These guys are hamstrings. Hamstrings. When these guys contract this way, that pulls pelvis this way. What happens to pelvis? That brings to posterior tilt. You want anterior tilt. But when hamstrings gets tight, that brings pelvis to posterior tilt. Thus, you need good flexibility for hamstrings. Then you can go more for anterior tilt. So you need good flexibility for hamstrings. Plus, when your pelvis goes to anterior tilt, your lumbar spines create more curve. This lumbar spine curve is called lordosis. Lordosis. You need good lordosis with anterior tilt. What kind of muscle inhibits lordosis? You see that? This muscle. This is psoas. Psoas is very deep core muscle. When this guy lacks flexibility, you can't get good lordosis. If you don't have good lordosis, it's hard to go to anterior tilt. Thus, what happens? It's hard to go abduction. Let me rephrase that. You need good flexibility for hamstrings, or you can't go to anterior tilt. Okay? If you go anterior tilt of pelvis, your lumbar needs to move together. This curve is lordosis. What kind of muscle inhibits lordosis? One muscle is this guy. This is psoas. You need good flexibility for hamstrings and psoas. Now, how about external rotation? What kind of muscles inhibit movement of external rotation? There are various hip rotators in human body, so I explain two muscle groups. One muscle group is these guys. There are six muscles in deep part of hip. This muscle group is called deep lateral rotator. Deep lateral rotator. Their function is external rotation. Wait a minute. It sounds weird. When these guys get tight, does it inhibit external rotation? Yes, it does. When the muscle gets tight, it can't do its function properly. Even though its function is external rotation, when these guys get tight, it's hard to go to external rotation. You need good flexibility of deep lateral rotator. Does it make sense? One more muscle I would like to introduce is this one. This is gluteus maximus. Gluteus maximus. This guy does external rotation. Again, when the muscle gets tight, it can't perform its function properly. Thus, you need good flexibility for gluteus maximus. Okay, review of today's theory. To accomplish 180 degree side split, you need good external rotation of hip and anterior tilt of pelvis. What muscles inhibit anterior tilt? There are two muscle groups, right? Hamstrings and psoas. Then what kind of muscles inhibit external rotation? That are deep lateral rotators and gluteus maximus. So you need to stretch these muscles not only for adductors. Adductors are, of course, important. These guys inhibit the abduction. So you need good flexibility of adductors, plus you need to stretch other muscles. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.